Hey there, UK EDCers and other interested persons. Al here, and today we're looking at this, which is the Walther MPK, an incredibly cheap little knife, just £12 shipped from Heini Hainz, 10 if you can get it in the wild. This is, I mean, for prices like that, this is, it's going to be made in China, isn't it? Now, that's certainly not a dig. I've had some incredible knives from China. Some poor ones as well, just the same as everywhere else. But of course, manufacturing is cheaper there. So generally when you get an ultra cheap knife, it's going to be poor quality from the cheaper side of things from China, rather than like a ultra high level craftsman like J-Made knives, or, you know, Beztech or Kaiser. You know, those guys are all in very, very good. But this is just a, you know, cheap, whatever job. So to be fair, you get a lot for your money. You get your free little pouch here, which is, you know, if you can remove your pocket clip there if you don't like it. You also get a pocket clip and a lanyard hole. So yeah, if you don't like the pocket clip, it's down there. Lovely. And there's nothing really wrong with this. I haven't used this, just the main reason being is that these, in my experiences on these cheap ones, the threading just falls apart. I also don't like that it says Walther there. Generally, when I have a pouch, I want it to either just say the maker of the pouch or nothing. I'm not looking to advertise what I'm carrying. Which brings me on to another quick point. No. Don't do that, especially not when it's a gun company. The box is actually fantastic, you know. Oh, Christ, this is made by Umarex. Nice. So yeah, it's actually a pretty damn good box for, yeah, it's, there you go. That's all it is, $9.95. But yeah, and just some free desiccant. So the actual knife itself, the scales on this, they're just plastic, but it's really doesn't feel that bad. It really is a nice plastic. Like, it's fine. It's a bit slippery, a bit slidey, but it feels nice. The texture there gives it an okay, like, more quality feel than it should be. The back plastic spine or spacer there, I suppose it's not really a spine because it's a detent ball thing, has jimping all the way down it for no reason. It's really poorly fit. One side I can see all the way through, and the other side is flush. Again though, tenner, you're getting a lot for a tenner. So it's a nail nick with a weird little thing. I've already shown this off in the thing. But yeah, so if you take a penny or a coin or a nickel or whatever you got in your pocket, that is now absolutely fixed. Don't know how it works. I'm probably going to find out in this video when I disassemble it. But yeah, so if you're looking to carry a UK legal knife, and you're, you know, look, that's now not legal. I am going to strongly recommend against anybody doing this. That's a reason I sort of don't like this knife. I can see a lot of people loving that though, because I know a lot of people really don't like the idea of a slip joint closing on their fingers. So long as you trust in the manufacturing of this, you should be fine. You'll certainly be safer with this than, say, you know, a standard one. But personally, myself, I don't have an issue using slip joints. Possibly I'm biased because I don't really have a choice. But I certainly don't feel strongly enough to want to carry this for that reason, for the ability to do that. So, you know, it's a feature. It's there. So if you, you know, if you're really looking for an odd, there we go, centering's back on. Yeah, there we go. So if you're really looking for a fixed blade that you can carry out and about, this would probably be the closest you can get while still having a chance to not get arrested, I guess. Again, an officer that knows what he's doing may well discover that. A court may well discover that. And for that reason, I'm going to strongly recommend against this. But technically, as long as you don't tighten that pivot, it falls within the boundaries. And let's not pretend like I couldn't take this out and use the tool to tighten that pivot, turning this into a fixed blade as well. So it's a very smart fix for an odd law for our nanny state. Eh. So it's an option, and a very cheap option at that. So I mean, that's why I've got it. Yeah, so the action on this is just fine. It's the standard, like the Fox Saru, just two detent balls in there, and they just fall into a detent hole, or one of two detent holes, the closed detent hole, the open detent hole. So there's no half stop on this, it's just straight out. There's barely any spring strength, because they're expecting you to use the thing there. The detent's okay, but you know, it's not the end of the world. It's just fine, you know, it is weak. And I'm fine with weak ones, but it's the bottom end of weak. It's, you know. I suppose it's not that bad. It won't collapse under its own weight, let's put it that way. So, washers, I'm going to find out later. And this is all just flathead all the way around. And a big flathead for the the pivot there. This is FRN with just stainless steel liners, I assume. Focus. Thank you very much. And it is, do you know what? It's tipped down, right hand carry only. So the grip on this thing, you got some like super aggressive jimping up here. just to see how good that jimping is. Because again, you don't know how rubbish. Look at that. I'm pushing down, like you can see I'm trying to close this as well. You don't want to be able to do that with jimping, really. The whole point is to give you some solid grip, but oh well. So there's jimping all basically most of the way down the blade, which lines up with that, whatever that is. Hey. There you go, that stuff. So it makes one of those. So the fit and finish in general on this is abysmal. Okay, I'm being too harsh on this. It's not abysmal, it's just poor. I wouldn't even say bad, I'd just say poor. If you're a knife snob like I am, you know, you up your own ass, you're gonna look at this and go, oh God. But if you're just a normal human being that doesn't waste all their money on knives, you're going to be like, yeah, that's all right, whatever. So that's that. It's 440C, which is, you know, absolutely fine steel from what I'm told. Although turns out apparently steel type doesn't really matter anymore. But yeah, so it should be an okay steel, but who knows now. There's a fair bit of billboarding all over this because it's, you know, made by Umarex under the Walther Black brand. So yeah, you've got your Walther, you got your 440C, you got your Walther, you got your Made in China, you got your Walther, you got your Walther, They paid for the brand. They're going to use it. I assume that's how that went. Blade Play. LOL. Yeah, there's loads. Just look at that pivot. Because of the adjustable pivot, can you see the angles that that's taken? However, again, if you use it as intended, illegally, yeah, there's none, but of course there's not, because you're screwing a pivot into itself. So, you know, depends. If you're going to be a law-abiding citizen, then sure. If you're going to be like, fuck the police, then you'd be fine. I'm going to say yes. Look at that blade. Oof, look at that bend. But before we scream and cry at how flexible that is, that is because it's very thin, and that does mean it glides through things. I've cut a few, I'm not going to lie, I haven't carried this a lot, like 2 times over the last month. I just, yeah. But you know, the times I did use it, and I did use it, it actually, you know, it raced through cardboard. It's a great knife shape, you know. It's the, that'd be a Warncliffe, would it? Or is that a sheep's foot? I think that's a sheep's foot because it's got the curved bit. Warncliffe's supposed to be like a flat, pointy bit, isn't it? Someone educate me. But yes, it does go through stuff, like, but it's fine. And, you know, it's very easy to sharpen. I've got a sharpener with a strop. Thanks to one of Paddy's videos, I actually purchased this. And I just take this to work with me. I think mine's an updated version because he's had to put a strop on the back, where on my one, they've given you this rougher material and you just add some compound, which I need to do more of. And that just becomes a strop then. And, you know, I need to clean that. And yeah, this is actually fantastic. This is insanely good. It's really, really nice to sharpen things on this just quickly at work. Like, it's discreet enough, it's small enough. It's not a review of that. But yeah, so you can really quickly reattain an edge on that. If you bork it on a piece of steel, like, this would be the one I'd lend out to people. If they bork it on a piece of steel, you can put an edge back on it with that thing. And, you know, just give it a quick, just a little strop, and you're off to the races again. It's really not bad at all. You don't really get a sharpening choil at all. And also to that end, see, I've got like, I don't know, like 2 millimeters of stop here. That cutting edge there is about 3 inches. Whoops, you don't get that on this side. That's a little bit over 3 inches. That's bad. That's bad. No. Naughty. So, you could very well be in a spot of bother with that. So, that's another reason I don't really like this one, which should be UK legal. But, I mean, it doesn't really cut there because this side's not sharpened. But bollocks is any police officer going to take your word for that. They're going to go, no, sir. So, yeah, it's a bit weird with that one. Stats on screen right now for you. Boom. And let's do a quick comparison with this boy. So, Wasp. UK PK. And because I'm going to make a little recommendation, a Swiss Army knife with the toothpick and the tweezers missing, because why would I still have them? I'm not brand loyal to anyone. There's a Wenger as well. They're all good, you know. But yeah, just, we'll come back to these. Oh my God. It's still hard to close that, manly, even with the mod. And for the US boys that get to have fun, you know, those things. So Yeah, you can tell it's actually getting pretty close to the size of that 940 there, which is not so great, to be honest. You don't really want that. Okay, I guess I'll do a disassembly. Okay, I'm just going to speed this up because, Asda, by the way. I'm just going to speed this up because hella boring, but you can still see how I do it. Boom, and you're back in the room. Okay, so there's the detent system. It does come with a stop pin. Detent. You get your washer. Yeah, plastic, nylon, Teflon. Who knows? Probably plastic, but you know they work. Same on that side. So yeah, when you're closing it, oh, it's a captive pivot, which is why you can only spin one side. Right, first little gripe, why would they make both sides like that if you can only possibly spin one side if this side's a captive there? But it makes sense to have this knife captive because I don't think the concept would really work if it wasn't captive. But, no, let's not do that. Come on. Oh, my God. There you can see the two detent holes that go all the way through. Oh, two detent holes for the detent balls there. Okay, so, right. This knife is fine. It's, you know, it's in danger of being a good little knife. I have a few small problems with it. Number one, the feature for this knife, the big sell feature, there we go, is that it's not UK legal when you want it to not be UK legal. Again, I'm not going to judge anyone for doing that because I think our laws are a bit silly anyway. So that's why I sort of don't like this. I think it's sort of undermining the little good faith we have left. But again, I'm not going to judge anyone if they wish to carry this because I can entirely understand. Like, I would love to carry something like this. You know, if I was going fishing or something, say, I absolutely bloody well would. But for my work purposes, I mean, where I work, it would be a bit of a stretch to say I need a knife. You know, I work at a restaurant, but, you know, more in the unpacking, like, clean, like, basically a porter rather than an actual chef kind of shit. So I could probably get away with it. Should probably leave that on screen. I would strongly recommend a Swiss Army knife over that. They're similar price. They do more. They're much higher quality. You can't go wrong. Like, look, I'm not the biggest fan of Swiss Army knives. I'm just going to put that straight out there. My problem with these, although they are fantastic for the money, like unbeatable for the money, is you often don't really know what steel you're getting. It usually just says stainless. And again, although like Super Steel Steve and all that lot and Love Them Knives in the Pocket and all those guys have pretty much shown that the type of steel doesn't really matter anymore. Like, it's more how, I mean, it does matter, but it's not the whole picture. It's from what I gather watching them guys, because those guys are the experts, they know exactly what they're doing. You need everything in a knife for the steel to matter. So, and at the moment it doesn't look like that's happening. But you get a bunch of tools with this, you get a damn good knife. You know, you get a knife that I abused because this was one of my very first ones, and you know, we all learn that they're not pry bars and screwdrivers somewhere, don't we? Sorry. I also bought this one. I don't play football. But yeah, that's for football cleats apparently. But yeah, they're all fantastic, you know. If you're looking just for an easy knife, the other great thing about these is, unless you come across the world's most anal police officer, you know you're going to be fine with a Swiss Army knife. So, like, I would just, this just seems like a much better deal to me. Much better deal. Respected company. It's not a gun manufacturer. I mean, if any knife in my collection is going to cause panic from being in my pocket, it's going to be this one. It says Walther on it. Everyone knows what Walther is because of Bond and such. And, like, look at it. Look how high that rides. it's not exactly discreet either. I mean, it's great colours. Absolute props for the colour on that pocket clip, which is then ruined by the bright white writing on it. Going, oh, look at this. But I don't hate it because it's not expensive enough to hate for being fine. It works. It does exactly what it says on the tin, and it does everything it says on the tin to an all right standard. That will do everything within the UK law that does better. They're just as easy to sharpen. They do come with a sharpening choil. Oh my god, I've ruined that blade as well. I haven't used this for a while. Look, trust me, I've had this since I was like 14. And that was about 15 years ago. So, yeah, I just, look, this is a good bargain. Just do it. Just get one of them. Just, there's no point. So, yeah, cheers for watching.